Hey, what's up guys, Jakey here. So this is my Wooting 60HE and I've pretty much had it for around 9 months now and it's been my main keyboard ever since I've gotten it. And I'm absolutely in love with this keyboard. It definitely provides an advantage in games like Valorant and Counter-Strike. Your inputs feel a lot more responsive and the rapid trigger is pretty much essential for games like Valorant and Counter-Strike where you Counter-Strafe. And even in Valorant, if you don't Counter-Strafe, when you let go of the key, your character comes to a complete stop instantaneously, and it just feels so much more responsive than your traditional gaming keyboards. If you guys want to see my full review of the Wooting, I'll of course leave that in the description for you guys to check out. But that is not what today's video is about. In today's video, we're going to be upgrading my Wooting 60HE so that it becomes my endgame keyboard, and I've bought several things to help with that. Now, I've watched a lot of Wooting modding videos, and I've listened to a lot of sound tests, and in my opinion, the Wooting will never sound as good as a fully custom keyboard. I think it has a lot to do with the steel plate, but I think Wooting is now selling a polycarbonate plate that you can swap out, which helps a little bit, but I think the main thing that stops the Wooting 60HE from sounding like a complete custom keyboard, or sounding as nice as a complete custom keyboard, is actually the magnetic switches, which I think limit the sound profile a little bit. I don't know, out of all of the videos I've watched of modded Wootings, none of them really sound like a fully custom keyboard, which is fine. I'm not really looking for a super custom sound signature. I'm mainly just upgrading it for the aesthetics and also just for it to feel a little bit more premium in the hand. With that being said, the original build quality of the Wooting is pretty good as well. Even though it's like a plastic case, the keycaps are PBT, and I really have no complaints about the build quality, but I just want my Wooting to feel a little bit more personalized and a little bit more premium. So with that being said, I picked up a Tofu Redux. This is in the white color, and I also got the brass plate along with it. I could have gone with the aluminum case from Wooting themselves, but I actually prefer the more minimalistic look of the Tofu, which is why I went with the Tofu. Not to mention the Wooting aluminum case is a lot more expensive. And then right here we have the brass plate. And then I also got the pack of 70 Gateron magnetic orange switches, which I will also be putting in. The reason I got these is because Bad Seed Tech said that they were lubed better than the original Leckers. They're actually very similar in actuation force to the original Lecker switches. I think the only difference with the orange switches is that the spring is like 10 grams lighter to actuate or something like that. So there's not really going to be much of a feeling difference between the oranges and the L60 Leckers switches that I have in here. At least this is going to save me a little bit of time so I don't have to actually lube the switches, because that would be a pain in the ass. Okay, so keyboard unplugged. Let me go grab some screwdrivers and we can get to work. I already have a switch puller here, so that's nice. And I guess first things first, what we're going to do is we're going to remove the keycaps. Okay, here we go. My cat is here. Again, very curious about what I'm doing. So I'm just going to take these keycaps off real quick. Okay, so I have all of the keycaps removed now. Now I'm just going to remove these, looks like 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, looks like 5 screws I'm going to take out so that I can actually take the PCB and the plate out. But I'm also going to re-grease my stabilizers with some super lube. This is dielectric grease. I'm just going to take the plate mount stabs off and then wipe off the existing lube on there, and then I'm just going to re-grease them. Okay, just like that, the plate just pops out. There you go. I'm also going to actually separate the PCB from the plate, but this is what the case looks like. And then I'm going to take the pre-existing foam that's on here and actually use this. I'm actually going to reuse this foam in the Tofu case. The Tofu case does come with foam, but in my opinion, I've listened to sound tests with the stock Wooting foam, and I think that sounds a lot better than the Tofu foam. I had to kick my cat out of my room because he kept grabbing at the screws, but there's 8 screws on the PCB that attach the PCB to the plate. So I just removed those. Feels a little tight. Let me just make sure. Separates just like that. Put that off to the side. And you also get the little plate foam here, which I'm going to save to reuse. If you guys are also taking out your switches, make sure you actually separate the plate from the PCB like I did. It'll make your life a lot easier when taking out these switches, because if you actually leave the plate attached to the PCB, these switches are super tight. You'll probably give yourself arthritis trying to remove these with the plate with the PCB still attached. So make sure you take out those 8 screws, and then it'll make your life a lot easier. Holy fucking shit, that was brutal. Yo, that took a lot longer than I want to admit, but my hands are all fucked up now too. Listen, take my advice, boys. If you're doing a switch swap, do not get a cheap switch puller like this one right here. This shit was so flimsy, man. Oh my god, you can still see the marks on my fingers. That was a battle. holy shit, but at least I got them all out. Anyways, now that the switches are out, I'm going to take out these stabs and then re-grease them. Okay, so this is the stabilizer for the spacebar. You can see here if my webcam will focus. It's already greased in there pretty well, actually. I don't even know if I need to re-grease, but I'm gonna do it anyways. All right, there we go. I have re-greased all of the stabilizers. I might have went a little too heavy on the grease, but whatever. Now we're gonna move on to putting in the switches. I have right here the Gateron orange switches, and I'm gonna be installing them south facing. If you run the RGB lights on your keyboard, then obviously you want to install them north facing. I actually compared the lubing on these. I held them up to my ear and pressed on the L60 and the Gateron orange. The Gateron orange is actually factory lubed better than the Liker switch. On the Liker switch, I can actually hear the spring ping when I put it next to my ear. But on the Gateron orange, I actually don't hear any of that spring ping. All right, there we go. All the switches are in. We have a couple left over. But yeah, I'm not going to be burger mounting this because I just don't have the O-rings. I didn't buy any O-rings. And I'm also not going to be tape modding this because I don't think it's necessary. If I don't like the sound profile, maybe I'll mess around with tape modding. But I'm not going to do any of that for now. But I'm going to assemble this now back with the PCB. And then we can move on to putting it in the case. Okay, so I've reassembled the PCB and the plate together. Now we unbox the Tofu Redux. Okay, on the top here we have, I don't even know, let me see. A little screwdriver, some screws, these three things, not sure what those are for, probably the standoffs I would imagine. And then I also got like these, I don't really know what these are for. I think they're just extra, but I'm gonna put these off to the side. Okay, in the case we actually get a little like pour-on foam, which again, I'm not gonna be using this one. I'm gonna be using the one that comes with the Wuding. And we have the actual case. Wow, this is very hefty. It's gonna be even heavier when we put the brass plate in. I was debating either between this, like this, the E-White, or the anodized silver, but I'm glad I got the white. It looks very clean. And then for the USB port, we actually have to switch this over to the W. I don't know if you can see that, but we actually have to switch it over to the W, which is what this provided screw is for. Okay, I slid it all the way over and then I tightened it back down. That's just to make sure that the USB port fits properly. Okay, cool. Let's put the brass weight in now. Here's the brass weight. Slides out just like that. We have three screws here, which I'm assuming is just to attach the plate to the case. Here's the brass plate. Very heavy. Not too concerned about the weight, but I heard that with the brass plate, the acoustics sound a little bit better, which is why I got it. Slide this guy in there just like that, and then we can put the screws on and tighten it up. Not sure why they give you three screws, but there's only two screw holes for the brass plate. Okay, there we go. That's in there. I still have like one leftover screw. I'm not sure what that's used for, but we'll never know. Now we just have to put the PCB in. Like I said before, I think we can only use one layer. So I'm just gonna rip off the top half and we're just gonna use the bottom. Just like that, my friends. Ah, I think I can use one of the standoff screws on this bottom part right here. Perfect, everything else lines up. I don't think I need standoff screws on these two. Maybe I do. We'll find out in a second. But now it's time to put this thing in. Holy shit, this thing is heavy. This thing is very heavy. I think we actually have to use the screws that come with the Tofu Redux. They're a little bit longer than the Wuding screws. Okay, make sure the USB hole lines up perfectly, which it does. This is so heavy, dude. This board, like, holy shit, this is heavy. But yeah, all the screws went in fine. I had to use the screws that came with the Tofu because they were a little bit longer. I probably could have actually used the original ones that came with the Wuding too, honestly, but it doesn't really matter. As long as that PCB isn't going anywhere, either screw works. Now, for the final part, we just gotta put some keycaps on here and we're good to go. Okay, time to put the keycaps on. The keycap set that I'm gonna use is an old one that I got from AliExpress a long time ago. Has Japanese letters on it, and I currently have it on my old HyperX Alloy Origin core here. This is what it looks like. We're just gonna be transferring it over. All right, guys, this is the completed look right here of the completely modded Wuding 60 HE. The sound test is gonna be after this at the end of the video, but I'm gonna give my thoughts on it so far. Honestly, with the sound, I didn't expect it. Like, I didn't have high expectations, right? Because obviously the watching all of the modded Wuding videos, I didn't have high expectations for the sound coming into it. And honestly, like I said, I was just modding it for aesthetic purposes, not really sound. But I'm actually pretty satisfied with how it sounds. Like, it does not sound bad at all. I think it actually sounds a lot more improved over the stock sound, which you guys will be able to see in a second here during the sound test. But yeah, no, the stabs sound, I think, better since I re-greased them. So yeah, I'm pretty happy with how it sounds. Definitely sounds better than stock, in my opinion. And the Gateron Oranges, honestly, they feel about the same as my L60 Likert switches, which, you know, is what I was expecting. I didn't expect the feel to change too much, but the lubing process on the Gateron Oranges are better. There's definitely less spring ping. They just feel a lot smoother, and they also sound better than the Likert switches, like the factory lubing on the Likerts. I kind of regret not getting the anodized silver. I feel like the anodized silver would actually contrast a lot better with these white keycaps, but honestly, I feel like this is a very clean look as well. And in the future, if I ever change out like the color of my keycaps, I feel like the white case actually will match a lot better with different keycap colors. So yeah, no regrets at all. I'm actually surprised. The one thing I'm very surprised about is how heavy it is. Like, obviously I knew it was going to be heavy because it's an aluminum case and I got the brass weight, but I did not expect it to be this heavy. You know, like, I honestly feel like if somebody broke in right now, I could use this as a weapon. Like, that's how heavy this thing is, but it makes it feel very premium. But the only thing is, like, I used to slide my keyboard around a lot. You actually can't do that, or actually can't do that now because it's so heavy. Plus, like, the two strips of rubber on the bottom just make this keyboard like stuck in place. Like, it takes a lot of force to move it. So if I'm like trying to reposition my keyboard, I actually have to pick it up now and like physically like move it around. But yeah, no, this, I'm pretty happy with how this turned out. I think it looks great and it feels great as well. So yeah, I hope you guys like this video. Sound test is going to be after this, but if you guys like to, make sure you do leave a like, comment, and subscribe. And I'll leave the links to everything that went into this build in the description below. That's pretty much it, guys. I'll see you in the next one. Peace.